How do you quantify inspiration? Is it through the number of ideas that you have? Is it by grouping together concepts or possibilities? Or is it just the sheer magnitude of energy that you have for a project, the enthusiasm that you have for it? This is a Lego brick, part of the intimate, infinite building system that has captured the minds of children and adults for decades now. It's part of a component of limitless possibilities. And in the past, there have been TED Talks that have spoken to about the Lego fan community of Lego building as a hobby or working as part of the Legoland parks, being a master model builder. But today I'm going to do something a little different, actually. I'm going to talk about an internship, a Lego design internship, to be specific, that I had the absolute blessing and pleasure of doing in Billund, Denmark, which is Lego's global hub for design. And so let's get started. So here's our trajectory for the talk. I'm going to talk about first my personal interest in Lego, and also the internship application, how I found out about it, some of the logistics that went into that. Next, I'll cover the global Lego community that is very much alive from here to the ends of the earth and very especially alive in Denmark. And then finally, I will talk about the 5 months that I had the pleasure of experiencing working as a designer in Denmark. And so kind of getting into the idea of what the hobby of Lego is, as you would expect with any sort of hobby, there's a lot of jargon and lingo that goes along into it. And I could spend an entire TED Talk explaining all these things, all these acronyms and what they mean. But I want to talk about one that's integral to the Lego hobby, and that's MOCS, M-O-C-S, which stands for My Own Creations. And so you arrive at a point when you're building with Lego that you are effectively such a fan of it, and you've been building with the instructions for a while, but you start looking at the bricks and you say, you know, I really think I could build fill in the blank, whatever you think you could build. And so you kind of say, well, the heck with the instructions. I'm just going to take these pieces that I've amassed from buying a bunch of sets or a bunch of parts and build whatever I want to. And so that's what I did with these two buildings here. These were both built in 2016. And when you build something really cool, you want to tell people about it, right? You want to share it. So where do you go to share? Well, at this point in your Lego hobby, you're like, I don't know if there are other people that are interested as much as I am. So you go online, and you basically find out that there are galleries where people post them. They also post them on major sites like Flickr or Instagram. And to take it a step further, you find out that there are conventions where people effectively share these Lego creations with each other. And that's pretty satisfying and pretty rewarding and energizing. So you do it more. You build more mocks. And as you get older, I started mocking about 2013, and around 2017, I'm graduating high school. I'm figuring out, okay, what is it that I actually want to do with my life? Could doing something that I enjoy, like building with Lego, become a viable career? And well, yes, in fact, it can. And so one morning, November 2017, I had recently created a profile on this job searching site, opting in that, yes, I'm interested in working in design, yes, I'm interested in working with Lego bricks, and yes, I'm interested in maybe moving to Denmark where they would have their design facility. And I got an email that said, are you an aspiring designer? Internship at Lego in Denmark. In short, I had forgotten to subscribe from all the robot emails and the spam, but I was really happy that I had forgotten because this is exactly what I was wanting to try out as a career, and here I get to experience it maybe in my sophomore year of college. And so portfolio assembly began. I began effectively compiling a lot of things together in PowerPoint. I put a lot of mocks, as you would assume, into the presentation, but I also wanted to try to diversify the amount of things that I put in there. So I also included this CAD model that I built in SketchUp. It's just like a cantilevered architectural house thing. I don't really know. I mean, I just built it in an afternoon. It was like, okay, let's build this. And basically rendered it and threw it into the portfolio to try to diversify and show my skill set. As you might expect, there were also a lot of mocks in the presentation. So there were a lot of my creations. And I tried to switch that up a bit by showing that I wasn't just proficient in building with Lego, but I could also translate that to maybe Inkscape or elaborate further about it, as I presumed model designers in Denmark would do for the sets. And so at this point, I submitted the portfolio to Lego. After many emails back and forth and a considerable amount of radio silence, I finally was able to get a reply, and they said they were very interested in hiring me potentially as an intern. And so I got my first interview, which was via Skype, and they told me all the different logistical things that I would be covering, transferring from the United States to Denmark. That also could be an entire TED Talk talking about all the paperwork that I may or may not still be having to fill out, but it was really fun because I'm getting more and more excited about it. This dream, this inspiration is taking shape. And so a second interview ensued. It was a phone call with my soon-to-be boss on the team that I was wanting to be hired on, but didn't quite know yet if I was going to make it. And so 3 days after that call, I got accepted. And so it was off to Denmark. And as I've said, LEGO has their design facility, which is right here in the small town of Billen, Denmark, population about 5,000 people. So considerably small compared to what I was used to being as a Louisville native. So I discovered that I would be working on a team called Creator Expert. They're responsible for a lot of the larger adult scale models where you have like buildings, kind of similar to the modulars I showed you, or larger scale vehicles. I found out that I was going to be working, in fact, with two of my favorite designers at LEGO since I've been a fan of since, I think, 10 years old, Jamie Berard and Mike Psyche. And I found out that Mike was going to be my brick mentor, kind of like my brick mate. So I was like, this is legit. Like, this is coming together. This is exactly what I was hoping to maybe experience post-graduation of college, and is now happening now. And so I arrived at Denmark, and LEGO was kind enough to give me housing at this place called Grauhøjen, which is about a 6 or 7 minute bike ride from LEGO Innovation House, the global headquarters of designs. And so I, on August 13th, 2017, 2018, excuse me, went into Innovation House, into the public atrium. And it's very Silicon Valley-esque. You can't really take pictures inside, but you can kind of describe what it's like. You have kind of a wood tile floor, blank walls, very white and inspirational, lots of natural light being let in with trees growing inside. And I'm just blown away by this. This is the hub of what I was wanting to see, and I see Mike and Jamie there, and they take me back behind the secret doors of LEGO. The light is pouring in. I'm so excited. They start briefing me on the next project that I'm working on. And I opened the doors, and I saw, well, I can't tell you. I signed a non-disclosure agreement, actually. So, maybe I can tell you, kind of, in the best that I'm able to give you a peek behind the curtain. So what does a day working at LEGO Design look like? Well, there's three things I want to cover with that. First, as I've described, it is a very creative and open workspace. Each designer team has their own little section that is allocated. You have desks and drawers full of regular bricks and lots of elements that you can effectively design with. LEGO as a company, especially in Denmark, abides by what is known as a rule of eights day, in which the day is allocated into 3 8-hour segments. 8 hours for work, 8 hours for relaxation or recreation, and then 8 hours for sleep. It's very well balanced and very effective and ensures the highest level of productivity and happiness for the LEGO employees. And then thirdly, the thing that I think everyone wants to kind of know is like, how many bricks are there? Well, speaking of quantification, it's very difficult to know how many. But to visualize, there are 31 or 30 grocery aisles long of shelves. Each shelf has 5 or 6 shelves tall, and each shelf section has 7 to 8 bins of LEGO, and each bin of LEGO has about 100 or 200 elements each. So you do the math, it's an exponential amount of LEGO that you have at your disposal. And that's really fun. When you're doing what task again? Well, let me tell you a bit about that too. So some of my specific tasks were building concept models. By the way, full disclosure, this picture here was taken in the public atrium with designer approval, just so we know I'm not violating any of the non-disclosure, but this is akin to how it looks a little bit behind the scenes. This is the visitor section part of the area that I first saw, which was pretty neat. But you're able to work on building concept models, so the creator expert team would say, hey, we're thinking about building X, Y, and Z. Would you mind coming up with a sketch of it in a 1 to 2 week time frame? We'll go to a design meeting, so I would attend meetings with designers and talk about a model as we're working on it. And then effectively, as the model develops and grows, you assist the designers with their models. Maybe this hinge needs to close more, or maybe this door panel has too many pieces, or maybe we just want to make it look cooler. And finally, with company-wide exhibitions, you would set up as different teams and effectively Show off all the designs that you made from either the present through the projected future, which I think was about 2021 is what I was working through, and all the teams would see their models. So those were my official tasks, but there were also fun tasks on the side, such as making smaller projects for internal affairs like birthday presents. So this next slide here is difficult to explain. These are the people that I had the absolute pleasure of working with, whether it were the 20-something other interns I worked with, the creator expert design team, getting to meet the owner of LEGO there in the blue, Keld Kirk Christensen, or attending a LEGO fan convention, as I talked about earlier, in Denmark. These people are what inspire me to build and to challenge myself, and I'm so grateful to these colleagues for having taught me as much as they did. So I'll return to the initial question that I'd asked at the beginning. How do you quantify inspiration? Well, the answer is you don't. Inspiration is determined by your imagination. Your imagination is this idea farm that's capable of infinite possibilities. It's the same message that all these other TED speakers here today have been telling you about. And the reason we keep saying it so much is because it has the potential to change your life for the better, to be able to inspire each other, to build off each other, to be creative. And so it was at that that I encourage you to go out, explore the world, build, play well, and inspire. Thank you.